Myself, Dr. Priyan, professor and HOD in City Department. Today's my topic is timers and in age of timer. Timers in age of timer. So, age of timer is having, so what is timer means? The timers are used to generate delay. In age of timer, the timers are used to generate delay. Okay. So, in 8051 we are having two timers, timer 0 and timer 1. Both these two timers are 16 bit timers. 8051 is having two timers, timer 0 and timer 1. So both these two timers are timer 0, 16 bit timers. The timer 0 is made into two parts, TH0 and TH0. TH0 and TL0, and timer 1 is made into two parts, TH1 and TL1. Timer 1 is made into two parts, TH1 and TL1. So that is the introduction about this timer. So these two timers, as we said, timers are used to generate the delay. Okay, so what is the source for these timers? Source for these timers is the crystal frequency that is attached to the 8051 is the clock source for these timers. Okay. So the crystal frequency that is attached to the 8051 is the 11.0592 MHz. So the clock source for these timers is the how much part the frequency that we are getting from the main frequency is 1/12 of the crystal frequency. 1/12 of crystal frequency is the clock source for the timers. 1/12 of the crystal frequency is the source for these timers. Okay. Then we are having, so for generating the different delays, we need a resistor, that is a timer mode resistor. So what is this T-mode resistor, timer mode resistor is? It is an 8-bit resistor. So lower 4 bits are given for timer 0 and upper 4 bits are given for timer 1. Okay. Lower 4 bits are given for timer 0 and upper 4 bits are given for timer 1. So this is M1 and M0 C/T bar gate bit. Same M1 and M0 C/T bar and gate bit. So this is the resistor, T-mode resistor, timer mode resistor, M1, M0, C/T bar, gate bit for timer 0, same M1, M0, C/T bar, gate bit for timer 1. Okay. So this M1 and M0 is the mode of operation for timers. If M1, M0 is 0, what is the mode of operation? If M1, M0 is 01, what is the operation like this? If M1, M0 is 00, it is mode 0 and it is a 13-bit timer. If M1, M0 is 01, it is mode 1, then it is a 16-bit timer. If M1, M0 is 10, it is mode 2, 8-bit auto reload. If M1, M0 is 11, then it is mode 3, 11 mode 3, split timer mode. if M1, M0 is more than 3, split timer 1. The records are missing. So if M1, M0 is 1, 1, then it is mode 3, that is split timer 1. Okay. So if M1, M0 is 1, 0, for example, if M1, M0 is 1, 0, 1, 0 means that is we are operating timer 0, we are operating timer 0 in mode 1. The maximum delay that we can generate is 16-bit delay, means 4 zeros to 4Fs. The maximum delay that we can generate is 4 zeros to 4F, like that. So based upon the mode of operation, based upon the mode that we are selecting, we will get different types of delays. 13-bit delay, 16-bit delay, 8-bit auto reload, or split timer 4. Okay. Then if C by T bar is equal to 0, then we are operating timer. If C by T bar is equal to 1, then we are operating the counter. The same timer will act as a counter, the same timer will act as a timer when C by T bar is equal to 0, when C by T bar is equal to 1. So what is counter means? The counter is used to count the number of events that is happening outside the controller. The time counter means it is the event counts the number of events that is happening outside the microcontroller. See, for example, I have connected a sensor to this microcontroller, where the sensor will be reading the number of vehicles that are passing to a window or passing to a door. Okay, so if one car goes from this end means, then the counter is incremented by 1. If second car goes means, then the counter is incremented by 2. So that is the number of events that is happening outside the timer, outside the counter. So that is the counter based upon the inputs that we are getting. So the clock source for this counter is events that is happening. The clock source, that is, clock source means based upon this, it will get 1 tick. The clock source for this counter is the events that is happening outside. The clock source for the timer is the crystal frequency that is attached. From inside, it will get the clock pulses. Based on that, it will count. But for counter, it will get the clock pulses from the outside. Okay. Then, what is the use of gate bit? G means gate bit. So what is the use of gate bit means? We can start and stop the timer by using manually or by using the program. We can start and stop the timer either manually or by using program. Okay. So program means how to start the timer by using instruction. By using instruction, we can start and stop the timer. For example, if you are starting the timer 0 means set BTR 0. This is the instruction that is used to start the timer. Then clear TR0, timer run. Clear TR0 is the instruction that is used to stop the timer. This is by using the program. Or manually means, like for example, if gate is 0, if you keep this value at 0, then it means we are starting and stopping the timer by using the program. If gate bit is 1, we are starting and stopping the program through manually. Generally, we'll keep by using program only. So this is the instruction that is used to clear, start the timer and stop the timer. Okay. So for example, by using the instruction, if I write like this, move tmod comma hash 01, which timer is selected and which mode is selected means 01 means here we keep 0001. That means we are starting and stopping the timer through program, and we are selecting the timer and we are operating in mode 1. So that is the meaning. we are operating in mode 1. So we are controlling the timer, controlling the delay by using a program, and we have selected timer 0, we have selected timer 0, and we are operating in mode 1. If you are writing the value as 02 means it will become as 10, then it will become as mode 2, 1103 like that. If you want to select timer 1, if you want to select timer 1, the instruction is simple, move tmod comma hash 10. So what is 10? What is 10 means? 0001 0000. So one hexadecimal number, these all are in hexadecimal number. One hexadecimal number is equal to 4 binary numbers. So 1 means 001, 0001, this will become 1. Then timer 1 we have selected. Then that is timer 0, like that we need to select the tmod instruction. Okay. So we will see with a small example, timer 1, by taking how to program mode 1, how to program mode 1, we will see with an example. So first we will see mode 1 programming. Mode 1 programming. So as I said, mode 1 means it is a 16-bit timer. Mode 1 means it is a 16-bit timer. 16-bit means the initial value will be 4 zeros and the final value will be 4Fs. After starting the timer will start from the initial value. How generally our watch will start? So like that your stopwatch will start. So like that it will start with the initial value. It will be incrementing one by one. Like if while running, they will keep a stop timer where it will be counting that count values. So similarly here also after 001, it will become a 001. Like that 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. After reaching this final value, again it will roll back to normal initial value. How your general timer will start 0 to 12, again then again from 1 to 12, like that. So like that here also the maximum delay that we can generate here is 4 zeros to 4, that is mode 1 programming. So how to program or how to write, so what are the steps that are involved in mode 1 programming is, so first we have to load value in tmod register. So what is the advantage of getting the value in tmod register is, after loading the value in tmod register, we select which timer and which mode we are operating. What is the timer that we have selected and in which mode it is operating? So we can clearly know by using the value that is loaded in the tmod register. Then from where we need to start the timer. So load that initial value. Load initial value in THX and TLX. Load that initial value in THX and TLX. See, for example, if you have selected timer 0 means, then I will write this as TH0 and TL0. If I have selected timer 1 means, then I will write it as TH1 and TL1. So X ranges from 0 to 1. Timer 0 means TH0, TL0. Timer 1 means TH1 and TL1. So we have to load that value from where I need to start the timer. See, for example, if I am writing the value as TH0 and TL0 as 000 means, that is I am starting the timer with the initial value as 4 zeros. Okay. So based upon the requirement, we can start giving the initial value in TH0 and TL0. Now that we have selected which mode that we are going to perform and which timer that we are going to operate, and then we are loading the initial value TH0 and TL0, TH0 and TL0. Then third step is to start the timer. Third step is to start the timer. Okay. Third step is to start the timer. Third step is to start the timer. Then keep monitoring the. So once if the timer is start means set B TR0, then it will start the timer. Set B TR0, then it will start the timer. Then it will start rolling from initial value to the final value. Then a flag is set. Then a flag is set indicating that a rollover has occurred. This flag is set indicating that a rollover has occurred. A rollover has occurred. Then the next step is to stop the timer. Stop the timer. Then clear the flag. Clear flag. Clear flag. Then go to step 2. Go to step 2 for repeating the operation.